Move on to the Arizona Cardinals, and I'm looking at a different site now, so I'm actually going to be able to spout off all of the seventh-round picks. moving away from the PFF draft board and whatnot. So, because for whatever reason, they did not list those last two picks.
That's weird.
Very I'd rather strange. You've pronounced that guy's name than... Well, I didn't even try. I just said I'm not.
I don't know why I tried. I'm terrible at names. I ruin them every single day.
That's how I would have done it. So... let's talk about the Arizona Cardinals. Went 8-8 last year. Pretty successful first year for Kyler Murray and whatnot, or whichever year for Kyler Murray. And things went well, I think, last year. 8-8, pretty good. That's about the same kind of record that Cliff Kingsbury used to have at Texas Tech. So, I think it's a step in the right direction. I like what they did in the draft here. Their needs were cornerback, wide receiver, running back, tackle, and tight end. And, we'll roll through the list here. First round, they take Zaven Collins, linebacker out of Tulsa. I kind of really like that pick. He was a culture setter at Tulsa. He changed the way that they play football in Tulsa, Oklahoma. So I always like that. Rondale Moore, wide receiver out of Purdue. Look, you give Kyler Murray some more weapons, you give him Rondale Moore, I am all over that. Yeah. Quarterback in the third round, Marco Wilson out of Florida. That was a good pick. Marco Wilson played really well for the Gators this year. Victor Dumukije out of Duke, an edge rusher. He's not Chris Rumpf, but obviously Rumpf was off the board. This guy was okay. I remember watching him play multiple games in the ACC this year. Tay Gowan, cornerback out of UCF in the sixth round. They got James Wiggins, a safety out of Cincinnati in the seventh round. Good guy to take a flyer on. He was a leader on that team last year. And Michael Minette, center out of Penn State. You need some offensive line help. Go and get a center out of Penn State, a guy that can hold up. I like what they did. I think this is a win for their draft. I like the strategy here I can actually see. And it looks like they are, they want their defense to be good. Okay, they don't have to be great on defense. They want to score points, and they are going to get dudes that can do it. I like what they're doing here.
Yep, I love everything that Arizona did. And let's not forget the fourth-round pick that they would have been theirs this year went to that DeAndre Hopkins trade. So I think you can just go ahead and plug in DeAndre Hopkins in the fourth round. I think everyone would say that's a win. I'm breaking Chris's rule, but that is and it's not like they gave up multiple picks. They robbed the baby dropper himself, Bill O'Brien. Would they give up David Johnson in a fourth-round pick and like a box of Wheaties for DeAndre Hopkins? And then the third-round pick they didn't have, they traded for Rodney Hudson, who's certainly going to bolster that offensive line. This team should have been a playoff team last year. If it wasn't, Kyler Murray got hurt. He had that shoulder issue, and he still tried to play through it. And it just – their offense couldn't get going. They had some bad performances against the Giants, et cetera. So that probably cost them a slot in the playoffs last year. This is a team on the rise. I know some people were saying it's a reach for Zaven Collins. I disagree. I agree with you guys. That kid looks like an absolute beast. The one thing I will say, the Cardinals are going to be a little thin in the defensive backfield, and they were last year. Patrick Peterson wasn't the same player. Obviously, he heads off to Minnesota. I would have liked to see a little bit more there. Teams are going to be able to throw the ball at will against this team. But if they can put a pass rush up and they've got the players, and we know they added J.J. Watt, which, whatever. I don't know how much you're going to get out of J.J. Watt. Probably not all that much. But I like what the Cardinals did here. I think this was a successful draft. And Rondale Moore, Zaven Collins, these are another team who knocked their first two picks out of the park. Then you plug in that third rounder they trade for Hudson, so you get Rodney Hudson, one of the top five guards in the league, with that third-round pick, DeAndre Hopkins deal for the fourth round. Cardinals hit it out of the park. Love what Arizona did.
So here's my problem. So I completely agree with everything you said. I like what they did. I think Rondale Moore is an unbelievable player, and he's going to kind of help that offense a whole lot because he's so versatile. He can do a lot of things. He's a freak athlete. Love Zaven Collins. Gary and I actually watched Tulsa because we watched the American Conference. Listen, right. I am a firm believer. I do not believe in this Power 5, G5 bullshit, okay? I think that is propaganda by the big boys, all right? Gary's Alabama football team likes to keep the little guys in their place. But the American Conference is head and shoulders better than the Pac-12, and they're right there equal to the Big 12. And it's not – and they're probably head-to-head with the ACC,
except for Clemson.
Outside of Clemson. And that's the list. Everybody else, I would take the American over the ACC from top to bottom. All right. And this is the issue is nobody gives them the respect because they see that little G5 and they don't think they're as good. Tulsa's a good football team that played other really good football teams and they beat them up. All right. They physically manhandled a lot of really good teams this year. And Zaven Collins was a part of that. Gary talks about he's a culture setter. Yeah. He changed the culture because Tulsa used to be an all offensive, throw the ball a million times, don't stop anybody team. He was one of the guys brought in, recruited to change that team around to kind of a defensive minded first team. I think he can be a help here. Here's the problem. Here's the caveat to all of this. Okay. I do not think you can be a mediocre ass coach in college football and then get promoted to the pros and all of a sudden magically become good at football coaching. Okay. I don't think that's a possibility. I think that pretty boy on the sidelines is going to get put in a phone booth and the hell beat out of him by every coach that stands on the other side of him every Sunday. All right. His offenses are pretty, they're flashy, but that's all they are. They're all flash and pop and stance. Okay. That's it. But there's no substance to him whatsoever. And I just think that at some point in time, the league is going to realize Cliff Kingsbury was a mediocre coach in college. You don't get to go from college to the pros and all of a sudden become a good football coach. That's not how this game is. It's way too competitive. The men that work on the other side work way too hard. They're just better than him.
Okay.
Cliff Kingsbury. Let's put Chris's number up on the screen for Cliff Kingsbury to go ahead and give Chris a phone call here.
Call me anytime. Don't forget to call me anytime. Cliff. Call me anytime. I just don't know how you do it. I don't know how you couldn't match wits with big game Bob at Oklahoma, but you think you can match wits with Kyle Shanahan?
No chance.
And are you insane? Am I taking crazy pills? No, you just can't do that.
Yeah.
I tend to agree with you. You know, I think he's got a lot more help at Arizona than he did at Texas Tech.
I don't give a damn. It doesn't matter. At some point in time, coaches got to coach in the pros.
Good Lord. All right. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at Chris B. Giannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.